So student, today our topic is from the lesson Physical Feature of India. Now our topic is Peninsular Plateau. In the first, I will tell you, this plateau region is formed in such a way. This region is known as a Peninsular Plateau. We'll see very clearly that it is in the southern part of India. So it is also known as Deccan Plateau. Deccan was called, or it was termed as very ancient time in India. It was termed from the Dakshina. Later it was known as Deccan. So many of the historians had started to term it as a Deccan in place of Dakshina. So topic is Peninsular Plateau. So when India was separated from the Gondwana land, I have told you the theory of the Gondwana land and Angara land. But after it, this plate was known as Eurasia, this plate was known as Gondwana land. Gondwana land where many of the countries were formed after the split of the plate from the Eurasia. So many of the countries were formed. India was one of them after Australia, Africa, South America and many of the other countries. So in the first I will tell you what is the plateau. You will see what is the meaning of plateau. Plateau means an area of land that is high above the land or the area which is around it. That is called a plateau. And what is called the peninsula? So peninsula means an area of land or piece of land that is surrounded by water on three sides: Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal. So student, I think you could better understand the both topic, both term, plateau and the peninsula. We will see that this is a plateau and this is a peninsula. I think most of the students can understand. It is known as Peninsula Plateau. This, it has two major divisions. One is known as Central Plateau, second is known as Deccan Plateau. A central plateau has the two plateau. One is called the Malwa Plateau and second is called the Chota Nagpur Plateau. So student, Peninsular Plateau is a tabled composed the old crystalline igneous and metamorphic rocks. It was composed through this type of the process of the rocks. It was formed due to the breaking and drifting of the Gondwana land and thus making it part of the oldest landmass. The plateau has broad and shallow valley and rounded hills. This plateau consists of two broad divisions. I have told you already. One is called the Central Highland, second is called the Deccan Highland. Central Highland is divided into the two parts, which is called, already I have told you, Malwa. The second is called the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Malwa Plateau lies between the Aravali Range and the Vindhyachal Range. You will see very clearly. And Chota Nagpur Plateau, it also between the Rajmahal Hills and other hills. Here you will see the Bundelkhand Plateau. Bundelkhand, also the region which is also known as the plateau. Small plateau, it is in the, we'll say, eastern part of the Central Plateau. The part of the Peninsular Plateau lying to the north of Narmada River, covering a major area of the Malwa Plateau. This is the region of the Malwa Plateau, and where we will see that this river, means Narmada River, divide the Central Plateau and the Deccan Plateau into the two part. You will see in the map also in the book that two plateaus are divided by the one river. The part of the Peninsular Plateau, the part of the Peninsular Plateau lying to the north of Narmada River, covering a major area of Malwa Plateau, known as Central Highland. This is the Central Highland. The Vindhyachal Range is bounded by the Central Highland on the south and Aravalli Range on the northwest. This is the Aravalli Range and this is the Vindhyachal Range. The further westward extension gradually merged with the sandy and rocky desert of Rajasthan. The flow of river draining this region, namely the Chambal River, the Sindh River, the Betwa River, Ken River, from southwest to northeast direction. But you will find the one more river is there. It is the Luni River. It is the longest river of this region, means western part of India. The Central Highland are wider in the west but narrow in the east. We'll see that this is the Central Highland, which is broader. It is wider here and it is narrow here. So you will see that in such a way it is wider and it is narrower. You will see the same thing here. Sindh Plateau is a triangular landmass. You will see the Deccan Plateau is a triangular landmass that is lies to the south of the river Narmada. You will find that it is a river Narmada, and you will see the Deccan Plateau in this area. The Satpura Range flank it is broad base in the north, while the Mahadev, the Kashmir Hills are the Maikal Range from its eastern extensions. And all these hills you will find in this area. In the physical map of India, you have to locate it. All the students, this is advice. The Deccan Plateau is higher in western and slope gently eastward. You will see one more important thing, that Deccan Plateau is higher in the west and slopes gently eastward direction. Means in such a way you can see. So student, the extension of the plateau is also visible in the northeast, locally known as the Meghalaya, Karbi, Anglong Plateau and North Kachar Hills. It is separated by the fault from Nagpur Plateau. Three prominent hills from west to east are Garo, Khasi, Jaintia. To find the three prominent hills in this region, these are the Garo, Khasi and Jaintia. Okay student, so now our next topic is western and eastern ghats of the Peninsular Plateau. So western ghat, you will see this is western ghat and this is eastern ghat. Mark the western and eastern ghat edge of the Deccan Plateau respectively. Western ghat lie parallel to the western ghat. They are continuous and can be crossed through passes only. Okay student, so they are very continuous flow and they are not any discontinuous form of this ghat. They are continuous form, and where you have to go through the places through the mountain passes. What are the mountain passes? The natural way that allow you to go move across the one place to another place in the hilly region. So you have to locate all these region in the map of India, like the various ghat, like the Pal ghat, Por ghat, Thal ghat, the physical map of India. The western ghat are higher than the eastern ghat. Their average elevation is 900 to 1600 meters. The height. If you find the height of this ghat, it is only 600 meters. This is a very proper difference. The eastern ghat stretch from Mahanadi Valley to Nilgiri Hills in South India. You will see they are start from there to there. Means from Mahindra Mahanadi Valley to Nilgiri Hills, you will find them. Nilgiri Hills is a kind of knot between the western ghat and eastern ghat. Eastern ghat are discontinuous form. You will see that this eastern ghat which are discontinuous. Means that which are not very continuous form and irregular and dissected by many rivers, because mostly the rivers are found in the Bay of Bengal and only the two rivers fall in this area. The western ghat cause the orographic rain by facing the rain bearing moist wind to the rise along the western slope of ghat. The western ghat are known by different local names which you have to tell. The height of the western ghat progressively increased from north to south. Means their height progressively increased from north to south. North to their height are becoming increased.
So these are the differences between the two ghats you will see.